Hey, this is Peter from Next & Web. In today's video, I will show you how to use Smart Slider to display your WordPress posts. In WordPress, if you go to the Posts menu point, you will see all posts you have on your website. With Smart Slider, you can automatically generate slides from these posts. First, you should go to an existing slider or just create a new one. Now, I would like to have a new slider with a box layout. Once the slider is created, press the Add Slide button. Then select Dynamic Slides. Choose WordPress Posts and Posts by Filter. In the first section of your generator's settings, you will find the filtering options. You can use them to filter the posts which you would like to display in the slider. For example, you can pull posts from a certain category. Or you can select a tag, and only those posts would be in the slider which have this tag. Lower, you can find the ordering options. For example, the descending post date order will show the latest posts. Under generator settings, you can set how many slides you want to generate. Each slide equals one post. The cache expiration time defines the frequency of how often new data are queried. If you press the View Records button, you can see what data will be available for each slide. If you finished configuring the generator, press Add to start working on the slides. This is the default layout of a dynamic slide. If you check the preview, you can see the slides showing your posts have the same design. Let's change the look of the slides a little bit. First, I will delete the unnecessary row. Then I would like to make the background darker by selecting a transparent color and turning on the overlay option in the settings of the slide. Now put down a heading layer. In dynamic slides, when you hover over fields, you will see little data buttons appearing. Press this button to select a variable for your field. At the top of the pop-up, you can see the available variables. Variables contain the data of your posts, like its title or description. In the middle, you can find some advanced generative functions. You can use them, for example, to reduce the length of the text in the selected variable. Also, you can search for an image inside the variable's content. At the bottom, you can see the content that the selected variable will show. Now, I would like to display the title of the post within the heading layer. My next layer is the button layer. Let's change the label of this button. This time, I would like to show the name of the post category. Go to the link of the button to select another data variable. The category link is what I need for this field. Now I will show you a trick with the text layer. Open up the variable selector of the text. Select the date variable and insert it. The way variables work is that you don't necessarily need to have just a single variable inside a field. You can have multiple variables and other manually written text next to one another. So let's copy this variable and insert another one. I will select the author variable. Now I can insert the previous variable in front of the author and write some text between them. Lastly, I would like to add the button that will lead to the post. At the link of the button, click on the data variable selector and choose the URL variable. Now the slide is ready. If you take a look at the preview, you will see all your dynamic slides using the same design you've just created. With the image variable, we are querying the featured image of a post. But if you have an image in the post content, you can display that too. First, you should select the variable which contains this image. In my case, it's the description variable. Then turn on the Find Image option. This finds the URL of the first image within the text. Insert it and the image will appear. Some texts, like the description of a post, can be quite long. Because of this, when you select your variable, you should also use the Split by Chars option. With Strict, you can remove an exact number of characters, which can cut words in half. If you want to avoid that, you can use the respec words option instead. This won't allow cutting off characters from words. Set the length to the character number you would like to use as the limit. When this feature is used, we also recommend using the filter remove HTML option. This makes sure that there won't be any unclosed HTML elements that could mess up your slider. Write three dots after the variable to finish the incomplete sentence. We have a lot of great-looking template sliders, but they are all just manual sliders. Let's take a look at how to modify these template sliders to use dynamic content. First, you should import the template slider you like. Then enter one of the slides. In the slide menu, select Copy, Slide. Now go to the slide list and delete all slides. You can do this quickly from the bulk actions. There you can select every slide and delete them with a single click. Now you should create a dynamic slide, just like you've learned. I will create WordPress posts dynamic slide, but in the pro version of Smart Slider, there are a ton of other sources you can choose from. The default settings will be fine for me. Go to the slide menu again, and now you should paste the previously copied slide. Then all you have to do is to replace the manually written values with data variables. Like at the background of the slide, I would like to display the featured images of the post. In the heading, I would like to show the title of the post. So this is all you have to do, just simply replace every value with variables, and you will get a dynamic slider with the same design the template slider has. In the pro version of Smart Slider, in the settings of the generator, you can find a group result option. This defines how many records are available on one slide. For example, if I want to pull two post data to a single slide, I change it to 2 and save the settings. Now I would like to have a 2-column row element. Each column should contain one image layer. If I go to the variable selector, a new setting will appear. In the groups, I can select whether I want to display the image, title, and so on of the first post or the second post. Now I would like to select the featured image of the first post. In the other image layer, I want to display the featured image of the second post. All I have to do is to select the second group and make sure that the featured image variable is selected. Let's add the title of the post to each column. Put down a heading layer and click on the data button at its text field. In the select group, you can set from which post you want to pick the variables. If you select the first group and pick the title variable, the name of the first post will be added. If I want to display the name of the second post, I need to add another heading layer. The title variable is already selected, so I just need to pick the second group. This is everything about groups and dynamic slides. Hopefully this video will make it easier for you to create dynamic slides within Smart Slider. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like, and if you would like to see more videos in the future, subscribe. Goodbye!